From time to time, I find myself thinking, why do I bother? Why do I care so much about these particular issues and not something else? Why do I see and feel the problems with Western culture as my own problems? At least to the extent where I bother to read deep and complicated literature and research material, and then proceed to mull over it for days, weeks, months, or even years. Why do I do this at all? Especially when it would be so easy and blissful just to sit back, relax, turn the TV on and not care. Actively choosing to never take particular notice of the seismic shifts within the culture and the world at large. Why is my mind constantly firing to the extent that I regularly feel the urge to awaken at all hours of the night just to write and express my thoughts? Why is it me and not somebody else who is an autodidact with a proclivity for analysis and an easy natural flair for articulacy? Why did I ever start digging for answers in the first place? And what is it that continues to pull me back in to keep digging? How am I able to blend together seemingly unrelated topics and materials time and again to write a coherent piece? And why have I been able to do this for many years despite a modest academic record? I wouldn't say I am particularly intelligent, not by my own standards of what really constitutes intelligence anyway, but I do have an ability to focus intently, and the tendency for anxiety and angst that leads to a sense of dynamic restlessness, particularly in the intellectual realm, where I feel compelled by something to constantly improve. Why is my brain wired in such a way? What spirit has gripped me? Is it a form of madness, a form of genius, or both? Throughout history, there have been many examples of deep thinkers, intellectuals, and creative artists who were blessed or perhaps cursed with an ability to explore the profundity of perception. It was a common theme that despite the fact that they were gifted with intelligence and many were considered geniuses, they were rarely actually happy or content in life. The life of the creative type, be they an artist, poet, or thinker, is not necessarily a fruitful one from a financial standpoint. As the American historian Brooks Adams wrote in his classic work from 1895, The Law of Civilization and Decay, from the 16th century downward, the man of imagination, unable to please the economic taste, has starved. Quiet, observant, in many ways anonymous, and often underappreciated in their lifetime. What they may have in abundance of intangible substance, intellectual depth, insight, or intuition, they can lack in material form. There's that famous scene in the 1997 drama film Good Will Hunting, where the character of Dr. Sean Maguire sits on a park bench with the tortured genius protagonist, Will Hunting. And whilst he acknowledges his brilliance, Sean also openly exposes Will's fraudulence, weaknesses, and vulnerabilities, which Will definitely knows he has, but is reluctant to truly admit as part of a highly developed defense mechanism. This is how I can feel about myself occasionally, and sometimes more often than I am comfortable to admit, a little fraudulent. Most of the things I have posted so far on this channel can all be learned and found in books, just like much of what Will Hunting recites comes from books. You just have to find them and actually bother reading them. It really comes down to basic curiosity. Unfortunately, despite having the free will and modern resources to learn about almost anything, the modern individual typically chooses to ignore all but what they are told to learn or told is useful to learn. Useful by what metric? Money making, it would seem. The spirit of the merchant, which now dominates the globe, and whose sole concern is capital, asks two questions. Can I make money from what I learn, or not? And if so, how much? I know that pursuing fields of study such as history or philosophy doesn't necessarily lead to financial success, and a thinker is largely underappreciated in a time of non-thinking. But what is the thinker to do in such a scenario? He cannot just turn off his mind and stop thinking. He cannot stop that which is natural to him. In reference to myself, I know I have a wealth of knowledge when compared to most, but it's knowledge that may not bring me wealth. And if financial wealth or property ownership is considered the measure of success, I would be considered unsuccessful, at least at the present time. And I know I'm not exactly alone in that assertion. In many ways, being an academic or philosophy specialist can be quite simple or comes naturally over time. If you invest substantial time into just reading and writing, as well as have friends or colleagues of similar levels with whom you can discuss ideas. Being proficient in anything only requires time and repeated effort. Although the more one studies philosophy specifically, the more one will begin to understand just how rare and therefore incredible original thought or creation actually is. Most ideas or presuppositions that people have came from far greater minds than their own centuries beforehand. Whilst throughout history, these great minds have written books, usually books that no one reads, or at least reads anymore, aside from strange people like me, which is why I am apparently knowledgeable and able to conceptualize things better than the average person, or perhaps even better than some other intelligent people, if I may be so bold. But in truth, I know I don't have all the answers, and try as I might, I may never find them. Naturally, I do know that I've been fearful and unhappy many times over the years when looking at myself, the world, and my life within it. Yet, I will, however, continue the search in earnest, because it feels right, it feels necessary. I feel an unexplainable compulsion to continue on, both for myself, and since I believe I am acting in congruence with my purpose, or at least some sense of destiny. Logic would suggest that I have been given whatever talent I possess, in addition to a troubled past of personal experience and circumstance, precisely so that I may share my gift, my passion, and my journey with the world for the betterment of myself and others, regardless of who may hear it or how many it may impact.